show you today how to paint some feathers onto a canvas bag. These canvas bags are fairly inexpensive at the craft store. You can buy them online. I have found some pictures of feathers online and printed them at a size that I liked and cut them out. I'm going to lay them out on the bag and decide how I'd like them to look. I have several sizes of brushes. One kind of large brush for painting a background. A very fine brush for some detail. And some medium-sized brushes for other parts of the feather. I have a bucket of water and some acrylic paint. Something to use as a palette. And for this one, I'm going to transfer the design by using charcoal sticks. So this is the charcoal that I use. And they're long, skinny sticks. I'll probably break one off. I'll be needing some tracing paper. This is a large piece, but you can buy this in tablets or by single sheets. And for finishing it off, I'll use some Mod Podge or acrylic gel medium. You can decide if you want shiny or matte finish. So to start, I've decided that I want the background to be sort of a blue field in the back. And I don't want the paint to go through to the other side. So I'm going to put a piece of cardboard in. This is just a filing cabinet piece of cardboard, a file folder. And I'm going to put that inside the bag so that it keeps the color from going through to the other side. I may want to paint the other side. I have put a little bit of white and blue paint on my palette. I'm going to mix those together to make a lighter blue. Not quite light enough, so I'm going to add a little bit of white. Usually when mixing a color with white, we'll start by adding just a little bit of color to the white rather than the other way around, and then you can control how light the color becomes. So I've mixed this to a very light blue, and I'm going to start painting a background. Where I'm going to put the feathers. Now this I don't mind if it comes out kind of brushy. I'm going to make sure that I don't get any wrinkles in there, and I can add water to spread the paint just a little bit more easily. Spreading nicely. If you'd rather have a square, you can make this a very even square if you'd rather. Now I need to wait for this to dry so that I can place the feathers on there. Let's see if these are going to be tall enough. This is enough of the blue paint. It looks like it is with the feathers that I've chosen. As the bag dries, I'm going to take one of my feathers and some of the tracing paper and put the feather under the tracing paper. Hold it really still and use my little piece of charcoal to trace around the outline of the feather. So now I have an outline of a feather on the tracing paper, and I can use that to transfer the design onto the canvas bag, and I'll show you how. I'm going to go ahead and put all three feathers on this piece of tracing paper. I'm going to trace all of them. So right now it doesn't matter their position. I'm just going to hold them down and trace the outline of these feathers. If you'd like me to send you a copy of these feathers so that you don't have to get them yourself, on my YouTube account there is business communication option, so you can send me a request and I'll get you these pictures of feathers as fast as I can. Keep in mind, if you don't want to use feathers, you can use whatever you like and trace around it. This method works for all kinds of things. Now I have two feathers. Now those are coming along. And I'll get the third one. Each one's just a little different, but I think they come from the same bird. Feathers on this paper, and I'm going to cut them out so I can place them where I want them on the canvas bag. Cut them pretty close. I'm trying not to smear the design because this charcoal will smear. So here's the bag. I still have the piece of cardboard inside to make it kind of stiff. And this is the fun part, to arrange the feathers on the background. Now this time I'm going to turn the feather charcoal side down. And place these feathers where I'd like them. I'll need either the back side of a paintbrush or something like a piece of wood to burnish the back of this feather charcoal down onto the page. So along the lines I'm going to just rub. You can use your finger, your fingernails as well. Rubbing along the charcoal lines, holding this really still. And it transfers the design. Burnishing charcoal side down from the tracing I made. Matt has left enough of an impression on the canvas that you can see the outline of a feather. And I didn't have to draw it. Now I'm ready to paint the feathers. choose whatever color I want. I think I'd like one of them to be a little more green. So I've got some green acrylic here. Them to be a dark blue. Keep in mind this acrylic paint, once dry, is permanent plastic on your clothing, so make sure you wear old clothes and an apron, and if you want you can wear gloves. It will rub off your hands, but if it's still wet and it's on your clothes, you can still get it off by washing. A bit of white paint too. So I've chosen one color for each of my feathers, dark blue, green, brown, and then a little bit of white for some highlights. I'm going to keep those feathers handy so that I can keep referring to them, because I want them to look like feathers. I'm going to start with the middle one, and following my lines, I think I'll start with a smaller brush. Trace my lines with this dark green. Feather with the dark green. I'm going to put a little darker towards the stem, but I'm saving the stem for last because it'll kind of help define it. Mix a little brown with that green to make a dark green towards the stem. It paints much more easily on the canvas if it's already been painted in the background. You could, even if you want the background to be white, it might be good to paint the white down first. And continuing to follow the lines that are on the canvas, but I continue to look at the original too. Feathers coming along. I just want to make sure all the ends come to points. for finishing the first one, I'm going to get just as far with color on the other two before I do finishing touches on this feather. So this one's going to be more blue. And I have my blue on my palette. And here I go. I'm going to outline that shape. Outlining the shape with the dark blue. Following the lines made by the outline and follow the outline. Now that each one has a base color, I'm going to use a little lighter version of that color by mixing it with white. So for the blue one, a little bit of blue mixed with the white. And I'll continue to follow the outlines and fill in the feather a little bit. Some more linear definition as the original feather has. So I'm going to use some permanent markers, Sharpies, about the same colors as are in my feathers. And I'm going to make some outlines and some inner lines to define these a little better. And at this point, I'm still saving the stem down the middle of each feather for black. End. I'm going to outline the brown one with a little more definition and lines. See those lines start to take shape. I'll do the same with the green and the blue. Thank you. The lines come out like tree growth from the stem where we haven't got the stem painted in, but you know where it is. And so little lines are coming out. I will use black and a little bit of brown. So down the middle of each, I'm finally going to put that stem in there. And then down one side of the black line, I'll put the brown line next to it. Take one of those black markers and put your signature. The final step is to cover the entire painted design with Mod Podge or acrylic gel medium. I'm going to use the Mod Podge with a very large brush. Just want to dampen the brush just a little bit first. And I'm just going to pour that Mod Podge right on here. And that'll make it nice and thick. Cover all the painted parts. Protective coating. When this dries, it'll be clear and ready for use. It'll withstand washing in the washing machine. I probably wouldn't put it in the dryer, just hang it out to dry.
Thank you. Thank you.